Order went up toward Debir from the valley of Achor and saw northward looking towards Gilgal, that is before the going up of Adumim, which is on the south side of the river, and the border passes toward the waters of the Enshemesh, and the goings out therefore were the Engorel, and the border went up by the valley of the son of Hinnom onto the south side of the Jebusite. Those are giants. The same is Jerusalem, and the border went up to the top of the mountain that lies before the valley of Hinnom westward, which is the end of the valley of the valley of the giants northward. So don't let nobody tell you that there was not giants in that old area. The old area, what they fighting the Israelites, that old area was polluted. That's why that land was given to Abraham. These Gibars, these giants, you see, these giants, people don't understand. That's the reason why we have these problems in society. That's why there's wars, rumors of wars. You got the Edomites, you got the Hagarites, you got all of these different influxes and different races that are Hittites, and they mix up with half-breed. That's why we have diseases, because they practice polygamy. They do interbreeding among each other. So we got children with coming up now, people having babies with children with tumors and all kind of disease with four legs, four arms, you know, all over the world. You have these babies that are born in six because brother would jump on top of sister would jump on top of brother, mother would, you know, you got all this evil practices, like the fallen angels. And Satan himself came down your soul and teach the children. And these things not ought to be. One of the main doctrines that they taught in the Sodom and Gomorrah was Sodomism and Gomorrahism. Woman with woman and man with man. And we're gonna go into that. And we're gonna look up those verses, those books, and we're going to write them down, because we want to go make sure that we understand that. Now if we look up Gomorrah, we're going to start in Genesis chapter 10:19, and Genesis chapter 10:19 is going to bring us back to Gomorrah. And we're not judging everybody, because God is the ultimate judge. But we gonna say yes to yes and no to no, you know, and we gonna teach the truth, and the truth hurts. And when we go into Gomorrah 10:19, the 10th chapter and verse 19, we want the children to know too, because the children them are confused. And it says here, I'm gonna start around verse 8. And they say, and Cush begat Nimrod, and he began to be a mighty one in the earth. He was mighty hunter before the Lord. Wherefore it is said, even as Nimrod, the mighty hunter before the Lord. And the beginning of his kingdom was Babel, mean confusion, Erech, and Akkad, and Calneh, in the land of Shinar. So we want to see where he went. Now we're going to jump to verse 19. It say, and the border of the Canaanites was from Sidon and Dokomis to Gerar unto Gazas, unto Goes, unto Sodom. So in that same area where we have problems, where the Israelites have problems, in that particular area at the Gaza Strip, it says here, the Gazas, though goest unto Sodom and Gomorrah and Admah and to Zeboim unto Lasha. And it said 20, these are the son of Ham and their family after their tongues and their countries and in their nations. And I want you to understand, these are the practices like these children did. These are the offspring of Noah. These are the children of Noah. And some people so proud, I'm a Cushite, I'm a Canaanite. But you see, you got to study to find yourself approved. These people practice idolatry and sodomy. This particular tribe, they practice sodomy. They and their families and their tongues and their countries and their nations. That's what it says here in verse number 20. Because you see, you must study the first five books. You got the descendants of Shem. You got the descendants, you got Cush, you got Nimrod. You know, he built Nineveh. Nineveh. So these are the Arkites, the people who came out the ark. They disobeyed the Lord. They did a lot of stuff that wasn't right with the Lord. You're so proud and to say you belong to that tribe. Go and see what your tribe was doing. Be a little intelligent. Genesis chapter 13. I think 9 and 10. Because these things are important, because they don't even teach us in Bible studies anymore. They quit teaching the old-fashioned way. The church has become an institution of business. It is a breeding ground for demons. The altar is supposed to be holy, 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 where the Spirit of God dwell and supposed to come in. But when you have all this Nephilim and all this Gomorrah and Sodomites on the altar, don't call on the Holy Spirit, because he might come in and all everybody drop dead. Beware. God is not mocked. Whatever a man saw it shall he read. And we're going to read now from Genesis 13 verse 9 and 10. And it says, is not the whole land the earth before thee? Separate yourself, I pray thee, from me. If thou would take the left hand, then I will go to the right. Or if thou depart to the right hand, then I will go to the left. And this is what happened to Lot. And Lot lifted up his eyes and beheld all the plain of Jordan, that it was well watery everywhere before the Lord destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah, even as the garden of the Lord, like the land of Egypt, as thou comest unto Zoar. And this is what happened because of the dispute among the family between Abram's shepherds and Lot's shepherds. It was a time to make peace. And then he said, go to the left or to the right. But for Lot, he thought the grass was green on the other side. But it's the practices that was going on in Sodom and Gomorrah. Anytime when you get too close to evil, the evil rub off. It's going to rub off on your wife, your children, and or something. And that's why you see like Lot had to go through all of this thing and raise. He bore two daughters. And the daughters turned around and intoxicated him and raped him. You see? Because of all what they saw happening in Sodom and Gomorrah. You say you're a holy person of God, but look what is around you. How can you dwell among the unclean? How can you enter into a church that you know your pastor is unclean, your bishop is unclean? How can you worship right here on the altar when you know the Sodomites and the Gomorrites are on the altar? You are cursing your very soul. And people, somebody have to speak out for God. So say, who shall stand against the devil? Who shall stand against the enemy? Who shall stand against the workers of iniquity for God and speak the truth? So God, children, them can hear and understand like they are doing wrong. Somebody have to blow the trumpet of truth. Somebody got to sacrifice themselves and say, for God I live and for God I die. I'm willing to put the truth out there. And no matter what, is one person alone can hear the truth. I've done my job.